Now I show you another kind of parsing, which is called shift-reduced parsing. It is very similar to top-down parsing, but the other way around. And it is named like the two rules it knows, which are shift and reduce. Now, because it's like top-down, but the other way around, we are starting with the empty stack. And here we have the rest input we want to pass. And well, in this column, again, we have the rule called initialize, because we have to start somehow. Then the first rule it knows is called shift. That means it moves one symbol from the rest input onto the stack. So here now it performs shift 3 times. It shifts the A from the rest input onto the stack. Then afterwards, it shifts the second A onto the stack again. And in the third step, it shifts the first B also onto the stack. So, and now you can see that this, the last part of the stack, those A and B, that are, this is the same as the right-hand side of one of our rules, and the shift-reduce parsing, because it's like top-down, but backwards, it now can take those right-hand side and exchange it by the left-hand side of the rule. This is called the reduce step. So, before that, it performs another shift step, which will not lead to a successful pass, but on line 4, because we have those A and B, which is the right-hand side of the rule, it can now perform the reduce step, exchanging those A and B by the left-hand side of the rule. So from line 4, we keep the A, we exchange those, the second A and the B by the left-hand side, which is the S, and we are now left with A and S on the stack. Now we can perform another shift step, moving the B from the rest input onto the stack. And now you see that those stack A, S and B, that is the right-hand side of another rule we have. So we can just exchange this with another reduce step by the left-hand side of this rule, which is another S. So, and now, because shift-reduced parsing is like top-down, but the other way around, we don't end with an empty stack. We don't end with an empty stack, but we end with a start symbol on the stack if the parsing is successful. The rest input has to be empty. So this line now shows that the parsing was successful. And, well, as you might notice, the shift-reduce parsing only took 8 steps, while the top-down parsing took, it was 13 steps. So the shift-reduce parsing in this case is shorter. And it's so in most of the time, because this is how we use the grammar. So we have at the beginning, the start symbol is like the root of a whole bunch of possible sentences or words we can derive. And then the non-terminals are like many possible categories. So if you are starting with a start symbol like top-down, there are a whole lot more possibilities for the parsing. While mostly for shift-reduce parsing, if you consider a natural language, one word has mostly like one or two possible part of speech text it can belong to. So shift-reduce parsing is in most cases takes less steps than top-down parsing because of the way we use our grammars and of the way we form our grammars.